Guys got to call timeout to run across the field.
And now we're going to get a conversation at the mound, I guess, to allow even more time for Jonathan Johnston to warm up out in right center.
Wow.
Johnston was the most used reliever out of the bullpen this year for Southern Miss. Didn't record a decision, but appeared in 28 games with a 4.93 ERA. So
maybe this is a ploy to get in Josh Adams' head or something, because
I think this is just a mechanism to give Johnston time to warm up, right?
2-0 count.
You get a visit to the mound from the catcher while the reliever runs out there. The minute the catcher squats back behind home plate, here comes a visit to the mound. Meanwhile, Johnston during this entire episode not only ran out to the bullpen, but has also thrown about 15 warm-up pitches. He is a submarine right-hander that is feverishly getting ready. So let's see if Cody Schlegel does indeed now deal to Josh Adams, and it looks like he will. Runners on first and second, no one out. Adams, hot shot, knocked down by Schlegel. It dies in no man's land. Running in to get it is James Ewing, and he can't make the play at first base. So Adams will reach on an infield hit to load the bases with no one out.
That's just a hot shot back up the middle. Josh Adams has waited on that slider perfectly, driving that ball up the middle. Good try by Cody. Good hustle by Josh Adams to get a single.
So Adam Dendecker will now come up with the bases loaded and no one out. And let's see, Schlegel going lefty to lefty here might stay on to face Dendecker, but this might be his last batter if he can't record an out here. First pitch to Dendecker, popped up on the infield, sky high. Coming in to take charge is Vollmuth, the shortstop, and he makes the catch for the putout. So Dendecker can't get the job done, and there's one away.
That's just a bad at bat by Matt Dendecker, because right there, the last thing you want to do is pop that ball up. You want to try to get on top of that ball with his speed. You know they're not going to double you up. Now you got nothing to show for but an out.
With a right-hander, Brandon MacArthur set to come up. Corky Palmer's going to make a pitching change. So that will do it for Cody Schlegel, and we'll get the submarine right-hander, the senior from Brandon, Mississippi. Jonathan Johnston will come on. This is the Gainesville Super Regional here on Florida's campus at McKeithen Stadium. Southern Miss and the eighth overall seed, Florida. The Super Regionals presented on ESPNU by Capital One. I'm Bob Wischusen with Brian Jordan. Both of these teams advancing to the Super Regionals with wins in the regionals last week. Florida right here at home in Gainesville took out Miami. And Southern Miss, very impressive on the road in the Atlanta Regional. As a team, they hit .336 with 12 home runs to knock out Elon and then Georgia Tech, beating Georgia Tech 2 out of 3. They scored in double figures in all three of the wins that they had in the four games last week. Arkansas has moved on, eliminating Florida State. They await the winner of Cal State Fullerton and Louisville, and Louisville needs a backup, a bounce back after getting beaten around by Fullerton last night. Virginia and Ole Miss, their series tied at 1 apiece, and LSU and Rice right now playing in game 2 of their best of 3.
Well, here, Florida's in another situation. If they let Southern Miss get out of this, bases loaded, no out jam, the momentum is definitely going to take over. As we saw last inning, when Southern Miss scored 3 runs.
Jonathan Johnston keeps it in the strike zone. 26 strikeouts to only 7 walks. Didn't record a decision this season, but he really is the prototypical middle reliever. He's going to come on. He will keep you in the game. 4.93 ERA is a bit high, but with aluminum bats, you're going to get batted around every now and then if you're inside the strike zone, but he doesn't issue many free passes.
Well, I'll tell you what, Brandon, or he's going to have to come through with, McCoffin's going to have to come through with a big hit right here. Cannot afford to either pop the ball up or hit the double play, and like I said, keep that momentum going Southern Miss way.
Cody Schlegel just came to the dugout a moment ago after the pitching change was made. And Corky Palmer apparently doesn't want his final season of coaching to end here in Gainesville as he reads the riot act to his left-hander. Pardon me, that was the new head coach, or the would-be head coach next season, Scott Berry, who's going to take over. He's the associate head coach, and he gets in the face of Cody Schlegel. Strike one to Brandon MacArthur.
Now, facing a submarine pitcher, you definitely, as a right-hand hitter, you definitely got to be looking to drive that ball the other way. You can't try to pull this submarine pitcher.
MacArthur gets hit with the bases loaded, and that'll force it a run.
Wow, that's, you know, that submarine ball will run in on righties, and that's exactly what it did right there. And good job by Brandon not trying to get out of the way too hard, because that's an RBI, hit by pitch.
What a terrible way to lose the lead. We just talked about the control of Jonathan Johnston. Only 7 walks issued this entire season, but a hit batsman with the bases loaded forces in a run. So Brandon MacArthur on at first. And that will tie the game at 5. And now we're going to get a pinch hitter for Florida as Tyler Thompson, another freshman from Tequesta, Florida. I like the Dave Matthews Band, too. I like his taste in music. His dad, familiar to many baseball fans, Robbie Thompson, an 11-year major leaguer and a 2-time All-Star.
You played against Robbie Thompson.
Well, you're old. I understand.
He's still a young man, Robbie.
So Tyler Thompson comes up still with the bases loaded and one man down. And it takes one just off the outside part of the plate.
Tyler's going to be a really good ball player. This year he's kind of struggling, striking out too much because he has so much speed to offer.
2 balls and no strikes. Last time we were in this situation, Southern Miss wiggled out of trouble. They've allowed 1 run here, but a double play ball would get them out of the inning. High pop up down the left field line, a long run for Cameron Brunty, the left fielder, in foul territory, and makes a sliding catch on the warning track. Tagging up and coming home to score is Preston Tucker. So Florida tacks on a run, but what a play by the left fielder Cameron Brunty to catch that ball in foul territory. Now you get into the debate, do you let the ball bounce to avoid giving up a run? I don't think so. I think that was a great decision by Brunty to go all out and try and get the out.
Well, it is a great play, but even a smart play on Preston Tucker, being in position, being in that tag situation, he was very aggressive. He waited for him to slide and make the catch. And not only him, but Josh Adams moved up on the play also. So smart base running by Jonathan Piggott. No, I'm sorry, Brandon MacArthur, who moved up from first base.
And Josh Adams moved up as well. Teddy Foster grounds one to short. The long throw from Volmuth ends the inning. So again, the damage limited, bases loaded and no one out. Florida strikes for a couple of runs, and they've got the 6-5 lead back.
Big day here on SportsCenter. Highlights across the sporting world.
Robert, let's start in the backyard with wiffle ball. The dad brings the heat, but the kid had a heater. Knocks the stuffing out of it, and he takes a digger.
He doesn't touch first, but that's okay. To the driveway. Big game of horse. Devastating if it goes. Oh, but she's off the mark.
That's going to haunt her. Now let's go to backyard soccer. He who hesitates is lost. Except this guy, that's a goal.
No.
This is once-in-a-lifetime stuff here.
The best highlights happen at home.
Take time to be a dad today.
Healthcare Alert. Daily registration limits have been established for all uninsured Americans. Register now for immediate acceptance. If you are one of the 47 million uninsured Americans, you are putting your health at risk. The New York Times, Harvard, and the American Cancer Society all state having no insurance leads to poor health and a lack of early detection of potentially fatal conditions. Don't let the high cost of insurance prevent you and your family from having the quality health care when you need it. Announcing open registration for an affordable national health care plan. Everyone is accepted regardless of age, medical condition, income, or residency. Call now and learn about a 30-day free trial for this national health care plan. You will be able to save 10 to 60% on doctors, hospitals, labs, prescription drugs, and more. Don't delay. Protect your family's health now. We will only accept 650 new registrations a day.
Call 800-865-6155 and start protecting yourself and your family. That's 800-865-6155.
You're watching ESPN's coverage of the NCAA Baseball Super Regionals presented on ESPNU by Capital One in the shadows of Ben Hill Griffin Stadium, better known as the Swamp. Here on the campus of the University of Florida here in Gainesville, there's the O-Dome, the O'Connell Center, right next to the Swamp and right next to those two buildings. A great ballpark for college baseball, McKeithen Stadium. It's a super sports complex here in Gainesville, and the Gainesville Super Regional sees a lot of Southern Miss fans make the drive over. They estimated it's about a 7-hour drive or so, and about 1,000 fans of the Golden Eagles made the trip here to see their underdogs take on the number 8 overall seed in the tournament, Florida. As we head now to the top of the 6th, Keating on the mound, Travis Graves will lead things off. He walked his last time up, that was in the 4th, and was stranded at first, flew out to right to end the 2nd.
There again, Patrick Keating starts off with a slider. I'm waiting for him to challenge hitters with that fastball, like he did right there.
New catcher in the game as well for the Gators as Buddy Monroe has come on, replacing Teddy Foster. One lifted out to center field. Den Decker puts it away, and there's one down.
And there, Bob, a fastball.
Someone's listening. Do you think they have the broadcast on down in the dugout? So Taylor Walker will face Keating now. With one away here in the 6th, we have had a back-and-forth affair. Two runs for Southern Miss, a run in the 2nd and a run in the 3rd, gave them a 2-0 lead, and then the 58-minute rain delay in the middle of the 3rd inning really changed the momentum of the game. After the rain delay, Florida came out against J.R. Ballinger, who they couldn't touch in the first couple of innings, and lit him up for 4 runs and knocked him out of the game in the 3rd. The 0-1 to Walker, swung on and missed. Nothing and 2. Florida would then load the bases with no one out in the 4th and fail to score. After that, 3 runs for Southern Miss at the top of the 5th gave them the 5-4 lead, but then Florida with 2 runs the last half inning, and they've got the 6-5 lead back. We've had 4 different lead changes through 5 innings. Southern Miss in their first ever Super Regional. The only 3 seed to advance this season to a Super Regional. A 1-2 line drive, base hit to center field for Taylor Walker. So he's 2-for-3. And there's a 1-out base runner and the would-be tying run on base once again for Southern Miss.
Good piece of hitting by Taylor Walker. He got that fastball out over the plate, and he stung that ball.
So now Bo Davis comes up. He doubled and scored in the 5th inning. Also a sacrifice in the 3rd. So he's 1-for-2 with a sacrifice. And comes up trying to get a Southern Miss rally going here in the top of the 6th. And that hit him. Keating comes inside and catches Davis on the elbow. The third hit batsman we've had in the past couple of innings. And now runners on first and second with only one man out for Southern Miss. And in case you're looking for the Texas TCU game, that game has begun. As we take another look, that came in and caught Davis on the wrist.
It's a hard sinker, ran in harder than Bo Davis expected.
As soon as we're done here in Gainesville, we'll get you to Austin for TCU and Texas. And it looks as if for now, knock on wood, I'm not going to pull Brian Jordan and completely jinx things, but it looks as if the rain has moved away as James Ewing is set to come up now with runners on first and second. Ewing doubled to left his last time up. He's perfect so far today. A single in the first, a walk in the third, a double and a run scored in the fifth.
I just like to see Patrick just go after hitters with that fastball. Got a lot of sink on that fastball, a heavy sink to keep that ball in the zone and get a double play right here.
Southern Miss turned the double play of the game when Florida had the bases loaded in the fourth and no one out to end the fourth. That was their 78th double play of the season, number one in the nation. There's strike one to James Ewing. Ewing was a second team academic All-American named by ESPN the magazine with a 3.73 GPA in philosophy. He had knee surgery back in February, so he missed 16 of the first 23 games this season. Sharp ground ball through the hole into right field for a base hit. Taylor Walker being waved around. He'll come home. The throw not in time. Advancing all the way to third base was Bo Davis, and on at first with an RBI single is James Ewing, and Southern Miss has come from behind again to tie the game at six.
Tell you, it's a ping pong match going back and forth with momentum. The pitchers are really struggling right now. James Ewing just did a great job. I mean, the hole was wide open there between first and second. He didn't look to do too much with a running and scoring position. Just the way you draw it up, drive the ball to right field.
So another opportunity for Cameron Brunte, who singled to right his last time up and eventually came around to score. Runners at the corners with one man out. There's strike one at the chest. Brunte's batting average up to 349. He's been on base two out of his three at-bats. The 0-1 just inside. They appeal to third. And Travis Katzenmeier says that Brunte didn't go around, and from here it didn't even look like it was close.
No.
He was barely
close,
barely even cocked his wrists.
Well, you know, fans.
It'll be a 1-1 to Cameron Brunte.
Only seen that play work once, and it worked on me. That's the only time it worked.
It's about to say that play never works. So I'm sitting next to the only guy in baseball history that got confused by the fake to third, throw to first kickoff move.
Well, actually, I've seen it happen this year with Chipper Jones. And Escobar was a double play turn.
Quick pickoff move chases James Ewing back to first.
Imagine that. They got a double play on that move. Got Chipper at first and Escobar at third base.
Another check to first base, chasing Ewing back.
This is a part of the game I don't understand. I mean, the bottom line is Patrick should be focused on his hitter, trying to get him to hit a ground ball and double play.
Well, Ewing has 3 stolen bases in 5 attempts this season. So obviously Florida is concerned that Corky Palmer might have a play on here. Here's the pitch finally, and it's fouled back. A ball and 2 strikes to Cameron Brunte. Brunte now with 76 total hits on the season to lead Southern Miss. James Ewing at first, Bo Davis at third in a 6-6 tie here in the top of the sixth. Game one between Florida and Southern Miss in this best of 3 in the Gainesville Super Regional. The 1-2, low and away. 2 balls and 2 strikes as Patrick Keating is trying to fight his way through the sixth inning. Again, Keating began the season as the ace of this Florida staff, but was moved to the bullpen, and he kind of lost his fastball. Kevin O'Sullivan said his fastball is back, and as a middle reliever, he feels he could be about as important as anyone on this roster for Florida. He's allowed only 1 earned run in his last 9 appearances coming into today, but he's already allowed an earned run here in the sixth inning.
And he's facing a hands hitter in Cameron Brunte.
2-2, lifted out to center. Dendecker settles under it, tagging at third on his way home. Bo Davis, here's the throw, not in time. So it's a sacrifice fly and an RBI for Cameron Brunte as Bo Davis scores. And a 2-run rally here in the sixth inning for Southern Miss gives the Golden Eagles the lead back. It's now 7-6.
Good sacrifice fly ball by Cameron. He didn't try to do too much. That was a ball down in the zone. Like Corky Palmer said, I mean, this kid hits with his hands. This ball's down in the zone. See how quick he got that bat through the zone just to put it in play. And Matt Dendecker did everything right. He stayed behind the ball, made a good throw, but not strong enough to get Bo Davis.
So with 2 away and James Ewing on first, here's Corey Stevens. Stevens reached on an error his last time up. He was the first player for Southern Miss to face Patrick Keating. 0-for-2 with a sack fly, hitting just under .330. And that's driven out to deep left field. On his horse is Barnes, and this one will one hop the wall. Rounding third is James Ewing. They're going to wave him home. Here comes the relay throw from Mooney. He'll actually put it in his pocket and won't even try to throw home. Scoring is Ewing, and it's an RBI double for Corey Stevens. And that stretches the Southern Miss lead to 8-6.
We said how Corey Stevens has been the hot hitter for Southern Miss. That's a slider down in the zone, and Corey just lifted that ball up. Good power by Corey right here. And Avery gave a good effort. Fielded the ball great, but good hustle by James Ewing from first base to come in and score for Corey Stevens.
So now with a runner in scoring position, still 2 men away, it's Joey Archer's turn. Stevens is on at second. No pitcher has had an easy time of it so far this afternoon. And the 5th total pitcher in the game is Jonathan Johnston, brought in last inning by Southern Miss. But Keating's now going to get a visit at the mound, as there's warm-up action down in the Gators' bullpen. That's the left-hander Tony Davis throwing, the junior from Cooper City, Florida, who has been very, very difficult against lefties this season. Greg Larson, a right-hander, a freshman from Longwood, Florida, also warming in the bullpen. So you've got double barrel action in the Florida pen. Three pitchers have already been used by Southern Miss, and we're still in the sixth inning. A game that started at 3:05 Eastern time. So it's well over 3 hours old as you toss in a 58-minute rain delay and 14 runs and 17 total hits.
And still going. Joey Archer, he's not an easy out.
Not even halfway through the sixth inning yet as Joey Archer faces Keating, who stays in the game and takes ball one just off the inside part of the plate.
I really think Patrick kind of lost his confidence in his fastball. He's just trying to fool guys with that slider. And you saw Corey Stevens, what he did to that slider.
Nice off-speed pitch by Keating. Strike one to Joey Archer. The 2-1 offering fouled straight back. Two balls and two strikes to the Southern Miss first baseman. He's 0 for 3 so far in the afternoon, but has hit the ball well. Lined out to short his first time up. A sharp ground ball to third in the third, and then flew out to center in the fifth. Corey Stevens at second base for Southern Miss. The 2-2 from Keating. A little flare out over second base, and it falls in for a base hit. Josh Adams can't come up with it. Rounding third and coming home is Corey Stevens. It's an RBI single for Joey Archer, and it's 9-6 Southern Miss.
Wow, Southern Miss just keep pouring it on. The ball Joey didn't hit too hard, but that ball had eyes right here. I mean, that was just a fastball running back across the plate. Got in on Joey Archer, but he's so strong, he's able to fight that ball off, and the ball had some eyes. RBI single for Joey Archer.
So now it's Michael Ewing's turn. Ewing came on back in the fifth, taking over in right field for Tyler Kaling, and he struck out looking his first time up last inning. Popped foul. A ball and a strike to Michael Ewing. Ewing, an original member here at Southern Miss, but his brother James, who was the starting second baseman for the Golden Eagles, transferred from Arkansas so he could play with his twin brother. Sharp ground ball just wide of first base. That close to an extra base hit.
Speaking of James Ewing, if he was at Arkansas, mild upset today over Florida State. Arkansas moves on.
And when they announced that score here at the Keithland Stadium, wasn't hard to tell what the fans thought of the result. The standing ovation given to the Razorbacks for beating the Seminoles from the Gator fans. Up and away.
Well, the Gators struggled against Arkansas all season long. I think they lost five games against Arkansas down the stretch.
It is about the in-state rivalry in every sport in this state. You got an SEC team, which you think would be the bigger rival, against an ACC team, and they cheered that the SEC team won and beat the ACC team. Two balls and two strikes. The count holds to Michael Ewing. Two again off the outside part of the plate. Missed with a fastball. Three balls and two strikes.
Well, Joey will be in motion on his pitch.
He'll get the head start at first. Preston Tucker's not even going to bother holding him on. On the outside corner for strike three called. So Keating ends the inning, striking out Michael Ewing. But Southern Miss strikes for four runs to take a 9-6 lead.
Your car works hard for you. Give it the fuel it wants. The hard-working gas from Phillips 66, specially formulated to clean fuel injectors, reduce emissions, and above all, help maximize mileage with every tank. Keep your car satisfied and help maximize mileage with Phillips 66, hard-working gas.
Are you one of the millions of people struggling to learn a new language?
Well, thanks to our breakthrough software called Rosetta Stone, learning a new language is now incredibly easy and a whole lot faster.
I've probably learned more in the first 2 weeks than I have in months of taking formal classes.
Rosetta Stone is so fast and effective, it's used by the U.S. State Department, NASA, the U.S. Army, and Fortune 500 companies, and is the world's leading language learning software.
It's almost like having your own person there teaching you, your own private tutor who is just very relaxed in your home with you, sitting there teaching you the language.
Rosetta Stone is the fastest way to learn a new language. And to prove it, we'll send you our amazing demo CD, absolutely free when you call.
This really is a great program.
I believe that you can learn any language with this program.
So call now or visit our website and see for yourself why Rosetta Stone is the fastest way to learn a new language, guaranteed.
Ryan Burt, Will Kimmy in studio. When Florida Southern Miss is done, we will go to TCU in Texas, and the Horned Frogs getting off to a good start.
Yeah, Taylor Featherston hitting his fifth home run of the year here. Texas Christian also hit two other balls to the warning track, one that Connor Rowe made a phenomenal catch on in center field.
One zip TCU, Texas with two on and nobody out. LSU and Rice tied at two. Rice needs to win to stave off elimination. We'll keep you updated throughout the evening.
All right, Ryan, thanks very much. Here in the Gainesville Super Regional, Bob Wischusen alongside Brian Jordan as we head to the bottom of the sixth inning. Ever since taking the lead in the third inning for Florida, it has been all Southern Miss, and I think that's something that Kevin O'Sullivan wanted to gather his team around to talk about. That was him there on the left-hand side of your picture sitting next to the helmets. And the rack in the middle of the Florida dugout. That was while we were away between innings. He gathered his entire team around and basically gave them the speech.
That's right. I mean, he's trying to rally those troops. And he said, this is a team that never panics. So I'm quite sure he's trying to get these guys to keep their heads. I think Patrick Keating kind of threw his glove, and that didn't look too good. Kevin O'Sullivan didn't like it.
Jonathan Johnston gets strike two on the shortstop, Mike Mooney. Mooney struck out looking his last time up in the fourth inning. Struck out looking with the bases loaded. Part of that inning coming apart for Florida when they had the bases loaded with no one out and failed to score. Now it's even up at two balls and two strikes. He lined out to right his first time up, so Mooney came into this afternoon hitting .320 on the year, but he's 0 for 2 today.
Jonathan Johnston has a lot of movement on that sinker ball.
Chopper towards second, James Ewing, and there's one away. Well, Florida has come from behind this season many, many times. They actually have come from behind in their last at bat eight times, and Kevin O'Sullivan realizes that can help the Gators.
It's one thing to talk about it, you know, about coming back, and it's never over to the last out, but until you do it a couple of times, it's hard to fathom that it could actually happen. But we've done that quite a bit this year, and you know, and all the credit goes to the players. You know, they've really battled through some tough times, and you know, now we get into a situation, we fall behind early, we feel like we got a chance to come back.
Well, they fell behind early this afternoon, 2-0 in the third, but came back to take a 4-2 lead. Fell behind 5-4 in the fifth, came back with two in the bottom of the fifth to take a 6-5 lead. Just gave up four runs, though, to see the lead disappear once again in the top of the sixth. Avery Barnes, who grounded into the inning-ending double play back in the fourth. Bluffs bunt, pulls the bat back and takes a strike. Two balls and one strike to the leadoff hitter for Florida.
And this is surprising because Avery's an aggressive hitter. To see him take strike one tells me that Kevin O'Sullivan is telling these guys to be patient, make the pitcher work, and let's get some base runners.
Yeah, I thought what Kevin O'Sullivan told us about Avery Barnes was pretty funny. It's almost hard to wrap your head around, but he said that he's a great hitter as a leadoff hitter, but he's not a good leadoff hitter. Sharp ground ball to second. Ewing retires his second consecutive batter here in the sixth, and there's two away. 9-6, Southern Miss has the lead over the 8-seed Florida here in McKeithen Stadium in the Gainesville Super Regional, presented on ESPNU by Capital One. I'm Bob Lachusen with Brian Jordan. This has been a back-and-forth affair. If you're tuning in to catch the Longhorns and TCU, we will take you to Austin as soon as we're done here in Gainesville. But we're still in the bottom of the sixth inning, a game that featured a 58-minute rain delay to go along with 15 runs and 18 hits. And now Jonathan Pigott comes up with two away here in the sixth.
Jonathan Johnson looks pretty good considering the struggles of the pitchers. He's getting ahead of hitters and going right after the hitters. Just as I say that, he throws his first high pitch.
You've been a jinx today. I'll tell
I
you.
Have,
you
I
you,
have.
You were talking back in the third inning about how shocked you were the rain hasn't fallen. And all of a sudden it was the Wizard of Oz about 5 minutes later.
I got to give credit to Scott, our producer.
Line drive out to left. Cameron Brunty was going to position himself to make the play, but then slipped and fell. So that will be a long single for Jonathan Pigott. There's some residuals of the rain delay we had earlier. Brunty had that one lined up. He was in a trot and just lost his footing.
Yeah, he had a beat on that ball, and because of that rain earlier, got to stay balanced out there.
But Preston Tucker is going to get a chance to hit here in the sixth inning. He singled to left his last time up. Part of the fifth inning rally where the Gators scored a couple. He would eventually come around to score. High pop up behind second base. Ewing settles under it and makes the catch. James Ewing involved in all three outs recorded that inning by Southern Miss. Florida puts a zero on the board. It's 9-6 Southern.
This commercial changed my life.
It all started when I used this free research service.
A computer and a desire to succeed is all you need.
With all the money I made, I bought a new home and a new car.
I love the freedom my home business offers.
Not working from home? Then you're missing out on your share of a billion-dollar industry. Visit this website now.
I make over $9,000 a month working part-time.
I make over $5,000 a month.
Start making more from your home today.
Log on to 93homeoffice.com now.
We've seen history being made.
Texas Western takes the first major sports title the school has ever won.
We've seen David slay Goliath.
In one of the biggest upsets in NCAA men's hockey history.
We've seen the best before they went pro.
Look at Urban Magic Johnson.
And now you can see it too. The greatest college sports video library of all time. Introducing the new NCAA.com, the official site of college sports.
Healthcare Alert. Daily registration limits have been established for all uninsured Americans. Register now for immediate acceptance. If you are one of the 47 million uninsured Americans, you are putting your health at risk. The New York Times, Harvard, and the American Cancer Society all state having no insurance leads to poor health and a lack of early detection of potentially fatal conditions. Don't let the high cost of insurance prevent you and your family from having the quality health care when you need it. Announcing open registration for an affordable national health care plan. Everyone is accepted regardless of age, medical condition, income, or residency. Call now and learn about a 30-day free trial for this national health care plan. You will be able to save 10 to 60% on doctors, hospitals, labs, prescription drugs, and more. Don't delay. Protect your family's health now. We will only accept 650 new registrations a day.
Call 800-865-6155 and start protecting yourself and your family. That's 800-865-6155.
Well, the Gators trying to keep their chins up. 9-6, Southern Miss has the lead through 5.5 innings of play, or through 6 innings of play, pardon me. A 9-6 lead for Southern Miss and a new pitcher in the game for the Gators. Freshman from Longwood, Florida, Greg Larson has come on. And you can tell he's a Florida guy. Dwayne Wade is his favorite athlete. I'm surprised it's not his sister Kim. D.A. Volmuth leads off this half inning for Southern Miss and takes strike one. Greg Larson's older sister Kim was a 5-time All-American swimmer right here at Florida. So she's my favorite athlete. Forget Dwayne Wade. Swing and a miss by Volmuth.
Greg has one of those tall, long bodies like a swimmer. But the book on him is he throws a lot of ground ball pitches. He has a heavy sinker. Throws that heavy ball like Derek Lowe in the major leagues.
This is up top of the fastball. Volmuth struck out his last couple of times up in the fourth and fifth. A solo home run in the second was the first run of the game. That was right before the rain delay. A little flare out into center field. Dendecker barely has to move, and there's one away. Boy, when you go to the bullpen, if you're Florida, often you are going to be going to a freshman or a sophomore or even a new junior college transfer. There are a lot of freshmen that are very important pitchers for this Florida team.
Well, that says a lot for Kevin O'Sullivan's recruiting. I mean, he brought in a lot of talented freshmen last year. His first year, he was fifth in the country ranked-wise with his recruiting class. When you have a resume like his, as far as a pitching coach, if you're a young pitcher, you want to come here and play for him.
Well, this is Greg Larson's 28th appearance on the season. And in that starting rotation, Nick Mirande, Alex Panagiotis, Anthony Sclafani are all freshmen around Stephen Locke, who started today. So you have a lot of freshmen.